Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's see all the basic features you need to know to start using Autodesk AutoCAD 2018. Please leave us comments in the video description to improve our future video guides on this software. Autodesk AutoCAD is a professional software used to create and preview CAD drawings, such as architectural projects, 2D plans, and 3D buildings. In this video, we are going to see just its very basic features in order to get started quickly. When opening AutoCAD, you will be directed to the Start tab, showing several sections. Use Get Started to start with a new document or open an existing one by going to Open Files. Recent documents list all the latest AutoCAD projects you have worked on, and the Notifications panel keeps you updated with the latest news from Autodesk. In order to see how to use AutoCAD, let's just start with a new project by clicking on Start Drawing. At this point, a new tab called Drawing 1 opens, showing the full AutoCAD workspace. This is composed by several parts. On top, you have several tools to edit and preview your drawings. On the center, a big preview on your current drawings. At the bottom and on the right, you have additional features we will see shortly. In this tutorial, we are going to see only the default workspace, but you can change to others by clicking on the small button at the very top. Also, if you don't find some panels, remember that you can reopen them by going to the View tab on top. Let's start drawing in 2D with AutoCAD. All the tools to draw and edit a 2D project are contained inside the Draw section on top under the Home tab. You can check each tool by hovering on these for some time, getting some more help and instructions on how to use these. Furthermore, some of these tools present a small white arrow. If you click on it, you will show other tools related to the one interested above. Use the Line or the Polyline tool to draw basic lines and segments. On the empty space, click once to fix the first point, and click once again to fix another point in order to place the first segment. So, you can go on clicking on the workspace to place other segments, sharing the last fixed node. Use the Escape key to stop drawing. Use the Circle tool to draw circles by fixing the first point to fix its center and another to fix its radius. Use the Arc tool to draw arcs by fixing three points on the workspace. In particular, there are several ways to draw circles and arcs, all contained inside their white arrow on top. Choose the proper tool depending on what you need, case by case. There are also several tools used to draw 2D shapes. Use the Rectangle tool to draw a rectangle by fixing two points. Use the Polygon tool to draw a regular polygon. Type the total number of sides first, apply with the Enter key, and fix two points by choosing any option in the list. Use the Ellipse tool to draw ellipses by fixing three points. While drawing, AutoCAD shows an instant preview of the object in progress and several useful information on it. For example, while drawing a segment, AutoCAD shows its angle with respect to the horizontal direction and the total segment length. By default, angles are measured in decimal degrees and the sides in decimal units. Indeed, this is not a fixed unit. You decide which is equal to the basic decimal unit, such as 1 millimeter, 1 meter, or 1 kilometer. To regulate the measurement units to use, just type units below and use the Enter key. While drawing, you can insert the exact length value on the current side by typing directly from your keyboard and applying with the Enter key. Remember that the object is placed when you fix enough points for it. To undo your drawing in progress, just use the Escape key. Also, when you finish drawing, the current tool is disabled. You can enable and use it again by pressing the Enter key. To enable one of the latest tools recently used, use the up arrow key to browse for it and the Enter key to enable it. Inside AutoCAD, you can draw objects more precisely and easily by using the snappings. In the bottom right corner, you have several icons. If you enable Snap Mode, you will snap to the intersection points of the project grid. If you do not need it, just click on its icon to disable it. You can also snap to drawings by enabling Object Snap. You can snap to several objects' points depending on the ones chosen from the list next to Object Snap. These points are well represented through green markers, endpoints through squares, centers through circles, midpoints through triangles, and intersections between objects through crosses. You can also use the green guidelines created by the green points shown. To disable object snappings, just click on Object Snap to disable it. Also, if you need to draw by following the horizontal or the vertical directions, you can try the Ortho Mode feature. When you don't use any tool, your pointer is in selection mode, used to check and edit all the drawings made inside your project. Let's check it. When you hover on an object, this will be highlighted, showing a box indicating several object properties, such as its kind and color. If you click on such object, this will be selected and highlighted in blue color. At this point, you can use the Property section on top under the Home tab to change the object properties such as its basic color, its line thickness, and line type. With the object selected, use the Delete key to delete it fast. To cut or copy the selected object, just use Ctrl and X and Ctrl and C. To paste the object, use Ctrl and V. And click on your workspace to place it. Let's see how to edit your object. When you select lines, circles, ellipses, and arcs, you will get some blue nodes on their center and path. If you click on the central node and drag, you will move the whole object where you like. Whereas you can use the other nodes to change the object shape. Hover on these to get quick information on the object angles and length, and click and drag one to edit the object shape. Click again to fix the modification. On lines and arcs, you also get a dialog box if you hover on a node for some time. Use Stretch to move the endpoint chosen independently in order to change the object shape. Use Lengthen to stretch the line length or the arc length without changing the basic object shape. Use Radius to adjust the arc radius. Very important are the Polylines, which are 2D objects used to create complete personalized shapes, either straight or curved. You draw polylines by using the Polyline, the Rectangle, and the Polygon tools. When you select a polyline, you will get big and small blue nodes on it. Hover on the big ones to get length and angles measurement, and use Stretch Vertex to move such vertex, editing the object shape. Use Add or Remove Vertex to add or remove sides from the polyline. If you hover on the smaller nodes, you can use Stretch to move an entire side and Convert to Arc to transform a straight side into a curved one. If you make any mistake, just use Ctrl and Z to undo your latest actions. Differently from the lines, the circles, and the arcs, the polylines do not have any central node that can be used to move the object. In this case, you have to use the Move tool inside the Modify section on top. In this video, we will see just the Move tool. If you want to discover all the 2D tools inside the Modify section, check out the next video of this guide. You can use the Move tool in two ways. You can enable the tool first and select all the objects to be moved, applying with the Enter key. Then, just click and drag from any object point to start moving. Or else, you can select all your object first and then enable the Move tool. Multiple selections can be important, since if you apply any tool, all the objects selected will be affected in the same way. Let's see how to work with selections inside AutoCAD. When your pointer is in selection mode, you can click on several objects to select all of them, but this may take a lot of time. If you click and drag from the left to the right, you will create a window lasso, a blue region that selects all objects that are fully contained. If you click and drag from the right to the left, you will use a crossing lasso that selects all objects that simply touch the green area. You can deselect a single object by clicking on it while holding Shift down. To deselect all, use the Escape key. AutoCAD also gives the possibility to quickly control your work. For example, if you use the down arrow key while drawing, you will open a list of several options depending on the drawing tool used. For example, while dropping a polyline, you can choose Width to change the line thickness or Arc to draw a curved side directly. While drawing a rectangle, you can choose Area to draw a rectangle with a fixed area. Very important is also the command line below. This is used to quickly enable any command by typing its name. For example, if you type Arc, a list of commands shows up with all the tools starting from Arc, such as Arc or Archive. Use the up and down arrow keys to browse for the right command and use the Enter key to choose one. Furthermore, while using a tool, you can use the command line to enable any of its options. For example, while drawing a polyline, you will find on the command line the same options to get on the small dialog box seen before. To enable one option from the command line, just type the blue letters of an option name and enable it with the Enter key. Let's now see how to check and preview your project in progress. You can zoom in and out around the pointer by using your mouse wheel and move around by enabling the Pan tool on the far right and clicking and dragging on your project. Use the Escape key to finish with such tool. Also, you can use the 3D View cube to check your project from any point of view. You can rotate your point of view by 90 degrees by using the hidden rotate buttons in the top right corner. To rotate freely, click and drag from the cardinal direction circle around the cube. The 3D View cube is also used to check your project in 3D. To know more about 3D environment, check out our related video in this guide. Very important is also the gizmo, the Cartesian system placed on your AutoCAD project. This is a reference used to locate the two main directions of a 2D project, the x-axis that represents the horizontal direction, and the y-axis indicating the vertical direction. You can click on the square node to move its origin and use the rounded nodes to rotate the reference system. Let's now save the project. Just go to File, and then go to Save As. AutoCAD projects are saved in a DWG format and are used to reopen and go on with your work later in the future. Thanks for watching this video. Have a look at our full guide to learn more about AutoCAD 2018.